Thank you, Honorable President, dear Mrs. Elvira and Mr. Andres. Thank you for providing insightful inputs on this global concern. It's unfortunate but undeniable that COVID-19 has deeply impacted people's lives from various aspects and raised severe health-related, social, economic, and fiscal challenges for all countries. I would like to draw your attention particularly to the effect of COVID-19 on socio-economic matters and state the solutions we can use to mitigate the aggravated crisis. Firstly, as the scale of the socio-economic crisis is not equal across all countries or within the population, we need to treat the groups most vulnerable to inequalities or having the least access to resources. For example, as 2021 is post-war period for Azerbaijan, an important share of annual goals were concentrated on disadvantaged groups such as families of martyrs, war veterans, and single households who lost the head of their families during the liberation of occupied lands. To these groups, Azerbaijan state dedicated a separate support plan which encompasses further expansion of social support measures, ensuring the sustainability of social payments, construction of social infrastructure in the liberated territories, and social programs including housing, car, and self-employment. Moreover, I am of the opinion that all countries need to analyze the employment losses recorded within their national borders. As a result of pandemic, to realize what labor groups and which sectors of work were affected by COVID-19 the most and where the government's efforts to revitalize the economy should be concentrated on. In this working, in this regard, the state of Azerbaijan designed financial support programs for employees working in the sectors immensely affected by pandemic, such as trade, transport, industry, and services. And of course, the businesses operating in the areas endangered by pandemic. I believe that to overcome the socio-economic crisis, every state needs to combat it first on national, but later also on global level by distributing financial aid to states with the worst defense system against the crisis. Finally, I join my fellow colleagues and advocate strategy, long-term vision, and ambition for transformative recovery on the European continent with strong green and social dimensions. Thank you for your attention.